Elsa's, it's me, Tears of Sephora, and in today's video, of course, I am not wearing any makeup, so you know what that means. It means I'm gonna try out the new Shiseido primer and liquid foundation. I am actually very grateful that influencers sent this to me to try out. So basically what I'm going to do is just try it out for you all and also wear test it and give you all my inputs on this new makeup that just came out. So with that being said, let's go ahead and open up the box. This is how it looks like inside the box. It is just super cool. It comes with a little pamphlet and of course the liquid foundation and primer, so here it is. But first things first, let's go on to reading the little pamphlet. It states here that this liquid foundation is a 24-hour hydration. It's also a luminosity invisible lift. It adapts to lighting, minimizes shadows and imperfections. Medium to full radiant coverage, and it is available in 30 shades. Alright, so this is the liquid foundation, and it has SPF 30. It also says in the back that it helps prevent sunburn, and if used as directed with other sun protection measures, it decreases the risk of skin cancer and early skin aging caused by the sun. So, like I said, that is really cool. I love the fact that it has SPF 30, so it does protect you from the sun, which is super amazing. And like I said, here is the box. If I'm not mistaken, the liquid foundation actually retails for $47. Alright, so this is how the liquid foundation looks like right here. Here you go. This is how it looks like up close. Okay, so far I'm loving the fact that it is actually a pump type of liquid foundation. I love foundations that have that kind of little pump thing. I just hope it works out because liquid foundation is a little darker than my skin tone, so I probably picked a wrong type of shade. I don't think this might suit my skin tone, but we will see. Alright, so this is the primer, and of course the box looks the same as the liquid foundation. The primer actually retails for $36, if I'm not mistaken, and this is a soft blurring primer, and I'm super excited to try this one out. Okay, so this is how the primer looks out of the box. Here it is, up close. Hopefully you all can see this. Alright, so now the fun begins. I'm gonna go ahead and try out the primer first. It looks like this. It comes with a little sharp pointy tube type of thing, so that's really interesting. I'm just overall excited. I like trying new primers, and this is really different. It's like, it looks like cream. It's white, actually. That's really different. I'm used to primer being like really clear. I don't think it really has a smell, to be honest. Nope, nothing really. I'm over here like, I can't smell. Does it not have fragrance or is it COVID? I'm just kidding. Oh my goodness. I could already feel that it is super duper light. It's very, very lightweight for sure. I feel like I need more because that just isn't really enough for my face. It just dissolved so quickly. So I'm gonna go ahead and add some more of it because it's super duper light. It honestly feels like nothing is there. That's how light it feels. Even on my hands, when I put it on there, it just feels super duper light. Like, there's nothing really there, and that's so crazy. And honestly, I don't even know if I like the fact that it feels light or if I hate it because it doesn't feel heavy. And it feels like I'm not actually applying anything. It kind of feels like it's absorbing into my hands than it is to my face, if that makes sense. So I don't even know how to feel about this primer. I don't know if I should like it or if I should hate it. I don't know. It's so difficult. Alright, so now that I already applied the primer, all I can say is that the title doesn't lie. It is the most softest primer I have ever actually tried. Literally super soft, extremely lightweight. It actually feels like it absorbs more onto my hands than it does on my face, if that makes sense, because it's just that light. Like, it's crazy, but I do know that it is on my face. It's just, it's kind of weird. I cannot explain it, so I don't know if I hate it or if I love it, because it's like, I love that it's lightweight, but then I also hate that I don't feel like I'm actually applying anything on my face, which is so weird. So I don't know how to feel about it right now. But we'll see how it holds up my makeup. Alright, so I'm actually terrified of now going into the liquid foundation because look at the way it looks. It looks like it won't match, but we will see because sometimes it's different from the bottle till when I actually put it on my face. So I don't know. So I'm gonna use two things. I'm gonna use my beauty blender to apply the liquid foundation on half of my face. And then after that, I'm just gonna use a brush to apply it on the other half of my face. That way we can try to see the difference with a brush and a beauty blender. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, that's how it looks like. Okay, I'm actually really, really nervous for this. It might make me a little darker, but we will see. Oh yeah. Yeah, that is way too dark for my skin. There you go. It is way too dark. Okay. I don't think I'm gonna like this only because it doesn't match my skin tone. Can you all see the difference? Like, I don't know. I kind of feel like it's blending, but I don't think it's the right color for me, honestly. That's the only thing I'm actually really sad about or disappointed, but I don't know. It was probably my fault when I took the little survey because I had to choose the color. Yeah, I don't know how to feel about this liquid foundation. Like I said, only because of the color, I don't really think it matches me. Like, you could definitely see a huge difference. I'm a little bit more light-complected here, and then here's the foundation. It's, like, darker. So, I don't know. I really don't know. I'm just like, help. Why? From what I could say is, I could definitely say it doesn't really have that much of a full coverage. I can still see my acne, like I could still see it right here and here. It doesn't really have that much of a full coverage for me personally. Like I said, I could still see my acne and stuff like that. So as compared to other liquid foundations that I've used in the past, it just feels like, yeah, it just doesn't give me that coverage that I actually want. I feel like this is more for someone who doesn't have like acne issues like me, that doesn't really need a full type of coverage, then this would probably work for you. But in all honesty, it doesn't work for me because I like to cover up my acne. Alright, moving on. So I'm just gonna go ahead and use my foundation brush and just try it out on the other side of my face. Here you go. Here's a close up. You can definitely tell, like I said, it doesn't really match my skin tone. I'm gonna go ahead and continue and applying it onto the other side of my face, but this time with my brush. Like, you can see the actual difference with my skin. It's so light, and this is way too dark for me. I wonder if my concealer will actually make a difference with this. All right, so far I feel like I would actually need maybe one shade lighter than this and then it would suit my skin tone. I don't know, but I mean, I feel like it does kind of blend in with my skin a little bit, but still, overall, I feel like it is way too dark. You can even see it on like here, because like as I am trying to match my neck with my face, you could definitely see like a huge difference with it. It's way too dark for me. But let's just try to ignore the huge shade difference that doesn't match my skin tone. So let's just try to ignore all of that. We can try. Let's focus on the coverage and how it feels overall on my face. So far, it actually feels very lightweight, which is really cool. My face doesn't feel heavy right now. So I like the fact that it doesn't feel like I have too much makeup on. Like I said on the pamphlet, it does say medium to full coverage, but personally, I don't really like the fact that it doesn't really have that much of a full coverage for me. Like I said, if you're someone that doesn't have acne, you know, that has like a clear face or whatever the case may be, this foundation may work for you because, you know, you don't really need too much of a full coverage. I mean, your face is already nice. Unless you're someone like me who has acne and wants to cover it up, this liquid foundation wouldn't be for you because it doesn't have that full coverage. Like I said, you could definitely see it right here. Like, you could still see my acne right here, or like dark spot. You could still see that. I think I do have acne like right here. Not too sure if you can see all of that, but there you go. I do, however, feel like it's a little bit oily. Like, it's just super duper oily for me because I feel like maybe this foundation is a little too hydrating for me. Like I said, I have combination skin, so I'm a mix between oily and dry, but it gets mostly on the oily side throughout the day. So I don't think this one actually works for me right now. I'm not really liking it, so I don't know. But like I said, this doesn't work for me, but it may work for you, especially if you're someone with like dry skin. I feel like maybe this will work for you, but it doesn't work for me because it's not a matte type of foundation. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and go in with my CoverGirl True Blend Concealer underneath my eyes and on my acne. So let's see if that makes a difference on helping me cover some stuff. Alright, so it's been a few minutes and I still feel like this foundation is still like really wet, I guess. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do my full makeup and all of that stuff really quickly and speed through it. That way I could just talk a little bit about it before I actually wear test it. And that way we can actually see if maybe using loose powder will actually help with this. Alright, so I just finished my entire makeup. I did it off of camera, but like the rest of it. So far, all I have to say is I'm not really liking this liquid foundation too much. Personally, like ignoring the fact that it's completely the wrong shade, I feel like it has made my makeup a little bit more cakey in my opinion, and I don't really like that. Like here, I don't know, here's like a close-up of like everything. Like up here, I mean, if you were to actually see it in person, you could definitely see all the cakiness like right here, as well as right here where my nose is at. I'm not too sure if you can see it on the camera and because of lighting, but for sure in person you could definitely see all of it being so cakey, and I feel like it bothers me so very much that I don't even want to have this makeup on my face too long because it's that bothersome. That's all I gotta say. Other than that, so far it is very lightweight. It doesn't feel really heavy or anything. But personally, I feel like this makeup product isn't for me. It might work for someone else that doesn't have like an oily type of skin tone personally, because it just doesn't work for me, honestly. Like I said, it has made my face look super cakey besides it not matching my skin tone, which you can totally see right here from the rest of my neck. So yeah, that's the only thing that bothers me. Let's just see if it basically lasted all day or if my face is gonna be completely oily. See you all soon in a few hours, and let's just go ahead and wear test this liquid foundation. So see you all soon. All right, so it is the end of the day and this is how the liquid foundation looks on my face. It is a bit oily, but to be honest, I'm actually really shocked with this liquid foundation because it has held up pretty good within these few hours of wearing it. It's already 8 p.m. by the way. So I think that's really crazy, and it surprised me actually because a lot of liquid foundations that I wear, they tend to get super duper oily, like extremely. Like, I mean, I know it's oily, like you can see on my cheeks right here. Also here, you definitely can see it here that it's oily, but I mean, I'm really shocked because it's not as extreme. Like I said, I've tried on other liquid foundations and like by the end of the day, it's just so bad, like super oily, that the makeup just doesn't even want to stay. It's already coming off and all of that, and honestly, this makeup held up. So I'm actually really surprised with that, and I'm actually proud of it, so yay! I'm actually proud that it actually stayed and held up for, you know, these past few hours. That's really good. Personally, I don't think this liquid foundation is for me, minus it not matching my skin tone. I just really don't think this liquid foundation is for me because it doesn't have full coverage. I have to apply concealer and other products to cover up other things like acne and my dark circles as well. So it doesn't really have full coverage. It's only light to medium coverage, just so you all know. So if you're someone that doesn't have acne or as bad dark circles like I do, then this makeup product may be for you. Also, if you do not have an oily skin type, this product may be for you because it is also hydrating. So if you don't have an oily skin type, it may work for you, but it didn't work for me. Personally, I'm just surprised it held up. Also, this liquid foundation is lightweight. So if you're someone that doesn't like the heavy feeling, then maybe this liquid foundation is for you. But that's also if you are okay with someone who just likes to have a light to medium coverage, because honestly, this one doesn't have full coverage in my opinion. So that's the only thing. Oh, also, I forgot to mention this one thing about the liquid foundation. I don't know if it was the liquid foundation itself or maybe it was a different product that I used, but honestly, my face started to get really, really cakey. It started getting cakey right here and all over my face, so I actually hated it. To be honest, I was actually doubting about wear testing the liquid foundation because of the fact that it made my face so cakey that I just didn't really like it. I was actually like contemplating like, oh, should I do this wear test? Because I was so annoyed at the fact that my face was cakey. So yeah, like I said, I do not know if it was because of the liquid foundation or maybe there was a certain product, like maybe one of my loose powders that didn't go well with the product. Like maybe the liquid foundation didn't mix with one of my loose powders. I don't know. So I'm not too sure if it was the liquid foundation itself or another product that just caused it. So I'm not really sure on that, but I've never had this issue with my other liquid foundations. That's all I know for sure. So maybe the liquid foundation caused my face to be cakey, but I don't know. It is something to think about. I do, however, love the primer. Okay, so I wouldn't say that I love the primer. I basically like it and don't like it. The reasons why I like the primer is because it is really soft. It actually feels like you don't have anything on your face. It's literally weightless, and I love that. But at the same time, I don't really like it being weightless because it feels like it's just absorbing into my hands instead of my face, if that makes sense. I don't know. So that's why I could say I like it and I don't like it at the same time. So it's kind of weird. I don't know. But like I said, I did feel like it held up my makeup pretty well. I would actually personally recommend it to those of you that don't have an oily skin type, like I said, because this liquid foundation is hydrating. So I feel like it's more meant for someone with dry skin type other than oily. Because oily goes with matte liquid foundation. So yes, hopefully I explained everything very thoroughly for you all, and I hope you all enjoyed this video just as much as I did. I was excited to try out a new product. I'm sorry that I've been talking a lot, but I hope that this video has informed you in many different ways. But yeah, anyways, let me know down in the comments if this liquid foundation and primer is something that you all would want to purchase in the future. Is this something that you would want to try out, or is it something that you really wouldn't want to try out because it's not meant for you? Or maybe you just didn't like it overall. I don't know. Just let me know down in the comments. And also hit that subscribe button and press that bell notification because I do my very best to upload every week. See you all next time.